good. How are you?
Doing good.
Great. It's like a dirty process to make fudge, huh?
It's not too bad.
It's not too bad.
You're a little bit sticky, but cleaning the tables and stuff, it's just a hot water and a hot rag.
Oh, crazy. That's cool.
Easier than you think it would be.
Wow. Yeah, I've never made this kind of fudge before, so. Made something sort of like fudge at home before, but
sort of.
Well, sort of. Because, well,
a fudge substitute.
I guess. I was trying to make this. My mom was trying to help me make this Brazilian dessert called Brigadeiro for my school project in 7th grade, and it wasn't forming, so we had to add dry milk to it, so it became solid, and it ended up tasting like fudge, which was pretty cool. Which is, it wasn't, dry milk wasn't even in the recipe, but it was cool.
But it worked out.
It worked out. I mean, nobody could tell the difference that it wasn't Brazilian, so. But it did taste like fudge, so. Do you do this all day?
All day.
Wow.
Like today, I think we made, how many batches did we make today? 14? 15?
Wow.
15.
And this is batch number 15?
That one is.
That one is? Wow. What do you do with the stuff that doesn't sell?
Like, what do you mean by what doesn't sell?
So do you sell everything, or
everything
goes?
At the beginning of the day, both those racks were completely full.
Oh, wow. So everything just sells?
Everything sells within 5 days.
Oh, okay. Oh, so it does stay over. I mean, you don't sell everything in the day it's made, though, right? Everything, or?
No, like, but everything that's, like, in the top counters that you see, it's only 3-4 days old at most.
Wow.
It sells, especially on the weekends.
Do you like refrigerate it or something? Or keep
it? You can't refrigerate fudge. It dries it out.
Oh.
You can freeze it, though.
You can?
Yes.
Good tip.
If you freeze our fudge, it'll last for about a year.
Sweet. Wow.
As long as you keep it frozen.
That means you can put it in the freezer and eat it later. That's nice. Cool. Interesting. Now what is the you guys put coconut on there? Is that?
Yep.
Oh.
This is German chocolate.
Oh, okay.
It's dark chocolate with pecans in it, and then there's coconut pieces on the inside and on the top.
Oh, wow. And does all German chocolate have is that coconut like a definite need for it or not is coconut necessary for German chocolate or not necessarily?
I believe so. Oh. I think all German chocolate has
coconut.
Some kind of coconut in it.
Wow. Cool. Nice.
Like you can see the giant ball in the middle.
Wow. Not much of a coconut fan, but I like chocolate though, so.
I'm not a fan of chocolate raspberry fudge stuff if anybody wants to try it. I got two fingers and I'll be
good. Oh, you want some? Sure, thank you. Thank you.
Why not? I'm gonna take that.
That was kind of messy, but good. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. That tastes. I've never had that before. I guess it tastes. It tastes nice, actually.
Chocolate.
With the raspberry and.
Oh, the raspberry. Oh yeah.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Thank you.
No, the raspberry is good though.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. Have a good night. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, guys, I just had this really nice freshly made dark chocolate raspberry fudge. You can see mere ungli pe. Yeah, but it's really good, really messy, freshly made. It's really nice, actually.